guys, welcome to Aaron's Automotive. In today's video, I'm changing U-joints on a drive shaft in a 1982 GMC pickup truck. So this truck is two-wheel drive, so there's a couple of things that we need to do first off before we even attempt to change a U-joint to err on the side of caution. First being, we need to chalk the wheels. So I have some cinder blocks over there and under that wheel to chalk them. But also, what I'm going to do for peace of mind in case it does roll down the driveway, I'm going to fire up the truck and I'm going to turn the steering wheel all the way to the right. Okay, I'm going to have to back up off of that wheel chalk first. There. A little harder to do. I can't do it. Hold on, bear with me. Drive over those chocks. Turn my wheels to the right. Nope, it's not gonna do it. Well, I was hoping to turn my wheels to the right so that if this thing were to roll down the driveway, it would go all the way right and not straight into the neighbor's property. Doesn't look like I can do that. So these wheel chocks will have to do. But second step is apply the e-brake. So e-brake applied. It doesn't look like that holds. Well, looks like I'm going to be replacing my e-brake cable on this thing too one of these days. Yeah, it just springs up, which means my brake release cable, or I think it's this thing that's jammed up, not allowing it to lock. Yeah. Okay. So forget about that then. Still want to be safe as can be. So I am going to throw a couple of these cinder brick chunks in front of the back tires as well. So if in the event it does try to lurch without the drive shaft in, it should help stop it. At least that's the theory. So next we need to do is crawl under the truck and get to the drive shaft. So we'll come right.
Hey guys, we're back. And we left off, I guess last I said I was going to be climbing under the truck and showing you how to pull the drive shaft, but there just wasn't much room under there. Front end's been lowered to this truck, so kind of lost a lot of room. Along with, the thing was just being a bugger to get out. Slip yoke was kind of rusted, so it took a lot of prying and pulling and pushing back and forth and packing full of grease through the Zerk fitting to try and get it to free up. Finally got it freed up, and then when I checked my U-joint parts, now these are the U-joint numbers that pulled up for 1982 GMC C20 two-piece drive shaft. Said that the middle and the rear U-joint were the same, and was saying the front was a 369. This is supposedly the front U-joint on the transmission. Turns out the transmission U-joint is a 331 along with the rear, and the middle is a 369. seeing as how I was only replacing the two U-joints, I was told that the 331s were the right, were both the same for the middle and the rear. That was false, so I had to go back, had to get the right part. In doing so, I already took out the old U-joint so that I could bring the slip yoke part with me to the parts store. So I'm going to reinstall this one with the new U-joint, but over here, I'm going to show you how I go about removing a U-joint using nothing but a hammer and sometimes a socket. So I get you guys set up on the mount here. And position you guys so you can see. And here we go. So can you all see? Yeah, you can see that all. Joint 369 is the one that I need. I'll open it up. There's the old one. Where's my clips? Okay, there's the clips and the grease fitting. I'm gonna put those aside for safekeeping. And here's the U-joint. Now what I like to do with U-joints, grab a little bit of electrical tape that I always, first I need to find out which way I want to orientate this. I want it this way, these ones, this way, okay, these are the ones I want. So what I do, I was just trying to figure out where I wanted the Zerk fitting. I'm going to take a little bit of electrical tape and I always wrap two ends. This keeps the caps from falling off while I install the other two, so you don't drop any needle bearings. That's the last thing that you want to have happen to you. So that should hold nicely. And you can just take the U-joint caps off. I prefer to tape them. That way I know exactly where they are. And checking the needle bearings. Make sure they're all right. They are. So, before I pound them in, you always want to take a screwdriver and clean out the little groove where the snap ring sits. I just use a flat blade, fits in nicely. Move it over. And I did mark already ahead of time where the U-joint sits. And my transmission's in park, so the splines haven't rotated. And the way I set it up was a piece of Sharpie here, and my Zerk fitting went to the right of it, so this will line up nicely and not shimmy down the road. So, I'm going to take off both of your U-joints caps. I'm going to drop the joint down and through, and carefully. Up a little bit. There's some of that grease and grime as well. Zerk fitting here. Oh wait, that needs to face out. Get to that. hammer. While holding the U-joint, I'll tap this down a little. A socket that fits the bearing, drive it down. Not all the way down, where you're pushing the other cap through all the way, but enough to where you can get the lock rings into place. Dropped into its groove, you take your socket again and not hit it hard, just a couple of love taps, make sure that's in there, spin the drive shaft around, drive this down. What you're trying to do is you're trying to seat this U-joint up to its clip. Along with drive this one down just enough to get the clip into place. Clip. Needle those pliers. screwdriver, act like a punch a little. Or if you have a punch, you can use a punch. Throw your screwdriver around. Should do it. Make sure that that's nice and clean. It is. That should be in enough now. Some more grime, so finish that and we'll come back. Alright, took a little more scraping to actually get that cleaned up, but got it. So, grab my socket. I'm just gonna give these a couple of quick glove taps. Make sure everything's nice and fluid in here. Nicely. So now we gotta assemble the yoke onto it. Same process. I'm going to wipe it clean a little bit. Clean up those ears a little. Give a quick spritz of some cleaner. Thank you. bit. Alright, well, let's continue, I guess. So, now you can take off your tape. Sometimes I hate doing U-joints without a press. Straight. this one in. Stiff again, so all you need to do is take your hammer and hit the yoke. Just slowly throughout its whole motion. Hit it once more over here. There we go. Now we just need to install or insert the grease fitting. It up now before I forget. You grease it until it starts to spew out a couple of spots on the joints, and then you're done. That's it. wasn't a bad, terribly bad joint, but this one is, and I'll show you why. So, there was absolutely zero needle bearings left in the caps. It was kind of chewing out the cap, or the... There, that's probably better lighting. It was starting to chew these up pretty stinking good. So, lock you guys back on. Now this has U-bolt straps on the other side, so that'll be an easy one. Grab my lubricant. Zip that quickly. I did soak these down previously, so should be fairly simple to get out. By the ears with the hammer. So that knocks the rust loose. And then smack it with a bigger socket. I guess I'll use the 19. Got a bigger socket. I'm using a framing hammer, by the way. Just falls out.
That old bunch of garbage.
not freezing cold out today. Only minus 5. So maybe we'll get a better look now at this cap. Or at the U-joint. She's pretty marred up. So I grabbed the U-joint for that one, which is a 331 from Moog. I know. Spicer would be a better bet to use. Alright. Found the electrical tape, got that taped up. I'm not going to remove the electrical tape at all until I've crawled back under the truck to attach it back to the truck and the transmission.
Are shaking pretty good, aren't you? Yeah.
Well, I apologize about that. Got you sitting on the truck box on the gun rail. So, nothing I can do about that. Straight in, no problem at all. So, knock it through with my socket till it clears the lock ring. Grab my bag of lock rings. Pliers. Thank you. proper into place. Under and reinstall that. So then I'll install my zerk fitting now, I guess. So I'm not fighting underneath it to do it. It. Like I said, I have no room underneath to show the installation or anything, so I do apologize about that. But regardless, that's how you change a U-joint using the simple good old hammer and a socket method. Next time I do U-joints, I'll show you how to use a vise on one half and probably a U-joint press, or it's a universal press for ball joints and U-joints. I'll show you that, I don't know, maybe when the motorhome or something needs U-joints on it. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, I ask that you give it a thumbs up, comment below. If you want to see more videos, I ask that you hit that subscribe button, which will be right somewhere around here. And also, I'll have a link over here to my other channel, my RV channel, if you guys want to go ahead and give that a check out. And yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Bye.